Ellie. Today my guest is Ellie Krieger. She hosted the Food Network's Healthy Appetite. It's one of the longest running shows that I know of on the network, and it's one of the best. Now, November is American Diabetes Month, and we're going to talk diabetes-friendly meals with Ellie Krieger today. Ellie, thank you, as always, so much for talking to us, because I know you're a registered dietitian, and you bring food, you bring no nonsense to food, but you make it fun.
Yeah, no nonsense, but lots of flavor, so that's really important. And when you're eating with diabetes or you're trying to prevent diabetes, it's so important to keep your blood sugar in check, but it's also important to know that you can have lots of flavor, that it's not a deprivation diet, and that also the foods that you need and the way that you need to eat is good for everyone in the family. So it's not like some special diet that you have to have, but this is food that's good for everyone. And I have basically three great examples, breakfast, lunch, and dinner here, these fabulous recipes to share with you to prove my point, basically. So for example, for breakfast, I have this Portobello Benedict. So it's like my take on Eggs Benedict, but instead of using an English muffin, I use a Portobello mushroom cap that I grill, and I use that as the base. And it's so savory and juicy and wonderful. It's perfect for this. And then on top, I put pesto, basil pesto. You can just buy it already prepared in the store or make your own if you like. But it's a great flavorful substitute for the typical hollandaise. And then I do just a sprinkle of real Parmesan cheese for lots of flavor. And it looks so beautiful. I've served this so many times for brunch, for friends. And you don't have to have diabetes to eat and enjoy this, but it really is quite diabetes friendly. Lunch, a wrap sandwich. So the key is, when you have diabetes, is watching the kinds of carbs that you eat and the amount. So making your carbs whole grain. If you're having a sandwich, make it whole grain bread. And watch the size of the bread. So use regular size pieces of bread or a wrap that's like 9 inches wide instead of a huge one that you sometimes find. And then I stuff it with vegetables and chicken and this great seasoning. This Asian chicken wrap is wonderful with this sauce that's made of a little bit of mayonnaise, but it has mostly yogurt. So it's creamy and it spreads beautifully on the bread. And then it has all these great Asian seasonings like soy sauce, a little hot sauce, a little sesame oil. And it's just delicious. So you're getting all that flavor, but lots of health benefits too.
And that's yummy.
It's really delicious, and it's actually my 10-year-old daughter, one of her favorite lunches, because she likes things a little spicy, but you could leave out the spice if you want as well. But then for dinner, salmon, which of course we all know is healthy and delicious and satisfying, but instead of serving it over a big bed of rice, I make this delicious chickpea ragu, which is so simple to make. It's perfect for like busy weeknights, but it's chickpeas, some carrots and zucchini, and it's in like a tomatoey, savory broth that's simmered until it's just nicely thick. But it's real quick to make, and it's so beautiful with the salmon. And so it makes it less starchy, more protein, more fiber, more colorful vegetables. So it's good for the whole family and great if you have diabetes. It can really help you keep your blood sugar in check and keep your nutrients up.
Well, you know, I guess you guys as professionals have over the years looked at people with diabetes, how they eat differently, because cookbooks that I see for diabetics almost look like cookbooks anybody can use.
Yeah, that's so true. And my cookbooks are not for diabetics particularly, but I do have a lot of diabetes-friendly recipes in my book. But for a website with all these recipes, including videos of me making these recipes and exclusive diabetes-friendly recipes, as well as lots of tips, you can go to everydayhealth.com/type2diabetes.
So that's a great resource for the listening audience, because there's lots of people I'm finding, I don't know the statistics, that do suffer with this disease in some form. I even hear people say they're pre-diabetic or borderline diabetic.
Exactly. And that's the time that you really, if you, what you eat and how active you are, the way you eat, and your activity level can really make a difference in terms of how you manage that disease. And in your long-term health, it can make a huge difference. So it can make a huge difference deliciously, and I think it's important to keep that in mind.
Well, Ellie Krieger, it's always great to talk with you, and I follow you on Healthy Appetite. Can you tell me some of the little things we can look for on Healthy Appetite on the Food Network?
Oh, gosh. Well, actually, the show's been on the sister channel, which is the cooking channel, And I am just doing all sorts of great recipes in there. And, you know, my latest book is Comfort Food Fix as well. So I have lots going on, and I've been spending a lot of time making yummy food in the kitchen. So that's also good for you.
Well, we'll get the cookbook, and we'll follow you on the cooking channel. Thank you so much, Ellie Krieger, for always hosting, always guests on the Valder Beebe Show. We really adore you.
Thank you so much, Valder. Take care now.